The following is an Eyewitness News special presentation.
This time I'm walking to New Orleans. I'm walking to New Orleans. I'm gonna need to parachute when I get through walking these blues. Get back to New Orleans.
When his death last October made international headlines, Antoine Fats Domino was called a music icon, pioneering singer-songwriter, and a titan of rock and roll. Eric Paulsen called him a friend. Tonight, Channel 4 presents Fats Domino, Eric Paulsen Remembers.
Good evening, I'm Eric Paulsen. I'm on the front porch of the house on Caffin Avenue that most people refer to as Fats Domino's house. His actual home is around the corner on Murray. This is the annex where Fats spent much of his time and where 14 years ago today, I was fortunate enough to interview Fats on his 76th birthday. Had he lived, Fats would have turned 90 today. Like so many other reporters, I had tried for years to interview Fats Domino, but he was pretty camera shy. However, on that day back in 2004, he said yes, and that interview developed into a friendship with a man I had idolized for years.
Well, this is really a cool room, though.
So you can be on television. Matter of fact, we're on television.
Yes, we are. Now, what's your for your birthday today, Fats?
Talk with you.
Oh, there you go. Tonight, we want to show you a side of this humble superstar most people never got to see. And much of what you'll see tonight, we have never aired before. Our interview started out like this. How does it feel being 76?
I feel fine, thank God.
And you look good.
Thank you, I feel all right.
I mean, what did you think you were gonna do for your birthday today?
Just sit at home and relax.
And then come on TV.
Yeah, I'm glad you did, because I wasn't expecting this.
You made your birthday for me today.
Well,
you know that? And we talked about it this morning on the show, and then I said, you know something, I'm gonna give Fats a call, see if he'll talk with us on his birthday.
Yeah, well, anyway, a lot of people wouldn't have seen me today. They'd see me on Channel 4.
There you go.
There you go.
And now you started playing piano when you were just a kid, didn't you?
Yeah.
How did that get started?
Well, my brother-in-law he used to play Papa Celestine band, and he used to play banjo and guitar. His name was Harrison Verrett. He's the one who taught me the chords, and I went from there.
And then did you keep on just practicing, or you just loved it so much?
Oh, yeah, I loved it so much. Every time I went, I used to deliver ice, I told you, I used to work on ice trucks,
mm-hmm.
and everybody had a piano, I used to stop. And the manager said, "What Fats at?" His son used to work with him. He said, "I don't know." He said, "Well, they got a piano over there. You better go look. He might be where he left the piano. Where the piano at? That's where Fats at. And that's where I would be. If I see a piano, I'd stop for a while and they'd come get me."
And you kept on getting better and better.
And yeah, because most of the time, all the houses had pianos, you know, the upright piano.
Yeah.
And everywhere I saw one, I tried to hit it a little, hit one note at least.
And did people like that when you play for them?
They must do. I don't know. They must.
And somebody. I mean, because let me ask you this. When you're on stage and you're playing, do you think about the audience being there, or you just get lost in the music?
No, when I'm playing one number, I'll be thinking, what should I play next?
So you're not thinking about the people out there?
Oh, yeah. I'm thinking when I be saying I'm thinking about what to play next, I'm trying to get a song, think of a song that I think the people would like to hear next. So while I'm playing the song I'm singing, and I'll be thinking at the same time, run across my mind, what should I play next? And that's why I go right into another number. You ever see me play?
Oh, yeah.
I don't like to stop. I like to keep going.
And people love it. I mean, do you love hearing the applause and everything?
Well, I love it, but I don't get, you know, I don't care too much about, you know, the applause. I just want to make the people happy. I just like to play.
Because you're kind of a shy guy, aren't you?
Yeah, I guess so. I don't know.
No, really. I'm serious. It took a long time for us to get to you to talk here.
Yeah, I know. But you called me the right time. I don't know why. Well, you know, I don't think I come across too good on television.
No, you do.
You think so?
Yeah.
Well, thank you. I never thought, I felt like I didn't look right on television. So.
What's scary?
But I love television, you know.
What's scaring me right
now, you know?
Yeah, what's scaring me right now is if my people see you, they may replace me with you. You, it'll be Fats and Sally Ann in the morning.
Ain't nothing wrong with that.
Yeah, but see, I couldn't come and play the songs, though.
Well, I'll show you. It's going to take a minute.
And now how long have you been Fats? I mean, how did Antoine Domino become Fats Domino?
Well, I was, you know, playing around New Orleans, and a fellow by the name of Billy Diamond. I was kind of small, and I started picking up weight, so he still called me Fats. So when we made my first record, we called me Fats in all those clubs. And I just made a record, and I just called the Fat Man, me and Dave Bartholomew, and they still called me Fats. So when I made my real name is Antoine, you know.
Yeah.
So I just called me the Fat Man. So I say, well, Fats Domino.
Hey, you know what? That was a good move.
Yeah, it was a lucky move too.
And now, when you got inducted into the Hall of Fame, the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, was that like a dream come true?
No, tell you, I didn't really think about all that.
Why is that?
Because matter of fact, I didn't really know what it was.
Really?
But I got, how you know I got inducted? You read it, huh?
Well, yeah, it was kind of like big news back then.
Oh, yeah.
It was in all the papers.
Oh, yeah.
And I want to thank the man who proved that the piano was a rock and roll instrument, Fats Domino.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Good.
Thank you.
And I mean, because not many people get into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. That's a pretty big honor.
Yeah, I've been very blessed. Thank God again.
And now, what kind of music do you like? I mean, what kind of music do you listen to?
I like country and western a lot.
Really?
I like rhythm and blues. I like most all of them, though. I don't dislike none of them, but that rap is going real big right now.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Don't tell me that Fats Domino is going to start doing a rap song.
No, I don't think so. Never could tell, but I don't think so. Never could tell what you're going to do, you know.
But you could.
I think so, because I know a lot of things that rhyme, you know, but I don't know. I haven't thought it would make none.
And then we talked about New Orleans, the city he called home till the day he died.
I love to live here, period. And even though it changed, but it don't bother me.
And what do you like best about New Orleans?
I like everything. I like the people, number one. And I like the food. I like everything about New Orleans.
And you like watching New Orleans TV, right?
Right. And you know, I watch y'all about 18 hours a day. I go from 14 to 15.
Hey, maybe we'd inspire a song.
Oh, when I was 14, now I'm 15. You know, that's how I get a lot of ideas like that.
You could do a Sally and Eric song. I think that'd be good.
Yeah. And tell Sally, I say hello.
I will.
You know, what I tell you in the back, I never hear y'all say nothing bad about nobody. Y'all always say nice things. That's what I love about y'all.
And like I said, we talked about you having a birthday today. And let me ask you this. Now, somebody said that you did a big concert, and they said one of the things you wanted, besides money, was a lifetime supply of Popeye's fried chicken. Is that true?
Well,
now somebody told. I swear to God, somebody said.
Well, I got a lifetime cord.
Do you?
Yeah.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
So do you use it like every day, or?
No, I just use it if some company come, or you know, I use it. Maybe once or twice, maybe once a week.
I use it last night.
You use it all the time, I'll let you
hear. Let me ask you this. If I want you to play a concert, all I gotta do is just bring Popeyes?
Maybe so.
You're like a real kind of down home guy, aren't you?
Well, I know I like to be home all the time now.
Now why do you like home so much? I mean, you got a cool house, let's put it that way.
I feel comfortable at home.
Now do you feel uncomfortable out around people?
Well, not like I used to, because I don't stay in those places too long.
Yeah.
I'll go visit for a little while, and that's it.
So do you keep kind of to yourself and with your friends and stuff, or?
Well, I ain't got too many friends, because I don't go nowhere too much, you know? But all my friends, they come here. I like to cook. They all come here.
Yeah. I'm looking here. You got some good friends.
Yeah.
You got
Wonderful.
Some good people here.
Wonderful.
And now, what was the inspiration for this room? I know it's all pink.
Well, I don't know. I just like pink. Always did. I don't know why.
Did you used to have a pink Cadillac?
Yeah.
Now, what happened to that one?
Well, I let it go with someone else, and I think I messed up in Betsy.
Do you still wish you had it?
No, but if I see one in that good shape, I'll get it, and I'll get it done. Oh, I think I'd like to have another one.
Really?
Yeah,
same I can model. See you. See, I like that Cadillac chair over there. Now, where'd you get that thing?
Oh, a friend of mine gave me that out of Boston, because he knew I had one like that, see?
Now, that's cool. That is really cool. Yeah. Now, see, I like that a lot. And now, when you first bought this house, you bought this about 50 years ago. Not this place, the house, the big house.
No, I built that.
Oh, you built that?
Yeah.
Okay. And then, because like you wanted to stay here in your old neighborhood, didn't you?
Right.
And I mean, because you still know people, I mean, you feel most comfortable here.
Yeah, I have everything I want. Nice people. Nice everything to me.
Yeah. I mean, for a lot of people, this is like the Graceland of New Orleans.
I don't know about that, but whatever, I still love it.
Because, you know, you've sold, in the 50s, there's only one person that sold more records than you.
Yeah, but I heard. That was my boy of his.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, even the Beatles thought you were pretty cool.
Oh, yeah. I went to see them in the 50s when they came down here. They wanted to see me, so they come grab me. And I went to see them.
Really? Now, tell me how that happened. What was that like?
That was all right. You know, matter of fact, when I played Liverpool, way before they made a record, they were the house band. That was my co-writer, Dave Patali, told me. Because I didn't pay no attention. I'm not going to stage. I just want to play my music. In fact, you just remember the Beatles? I said, no. He said, they played for you in Liverpool before they made a record.
So they were your opening act?
Well, yeah, but I didn't know, you know. But they was the open act, you know, for the club, I guess, you know. Boy, they did a lot of good, too.
Yeah. And the Beatles probably were looking at Fats Domino going, wow, it's Fats Domino.
I don't know.
Oh, I bet they were.
Maybe so. I don't know.
I bet they were.
I never thought I'd be here with you, like you said before. It's a surprise to me. I'm glad you called.
Fats, it's the best day of my life.
Okay, thank you. And I'll be watching you all forever.
I'm telling you what, this is. I hope it's a good birthday for you.
I think it is. You made my day. Like people tell me that all the time, so I really mean that. You made my day.
Fats, you're the best.
Thank you, Eric.
Right after that, we went into Fats' music room, and he put on a mini concert for us. And this is where you see the really playful side of Fats Domino.
This time I'm a different key. Huh? Cut that off here, boss. Cut that off. This time, yeah.
That's because you don't usually play the bum,
yeah.
The guitar.
This time I'm walking to New Orleans. I'm walking to New Orleans. I'm gonna need to parachute when I get through walking these blues. When I get back to New Orleans. I've got this baseball here. This
you want me to do it?
I got no time for walking. I've got to keep a talking. Cause New Orleans is my home. That's the reason why I'm gone. If I'm walking to New Orleans.
Yeah. Oh, man. That was a very special day for me here on Caffin Avenue 14 years ago today, and the beginning of a friendship that would last until the day Fats passed. We have more Fats Domino memories coming up after the break. Stay right there.
You went away and left me long time ago. And now you come back knocking on my door.
Fats Domino died in October of last year, here in this house in Harvey, where he moved after Hurricane Katrina. When you step inside Fats Domino's house, the first thing that catches your eye is that beautiful pink Cadillac couch. But there's also a piano here. It is Fats Domino, and sometimes he'd play impromptu concerts for us.
I like that one, Fats. See, you gotta play the piano more.
Oftentimes, Fats was joined by musician friends like John Cleary and Chubby Checker. After Hurricane Katrina hit, we were with Fats when he went back to his Ninth Ward home.
You still won't go?
Yeah, come on, Fats.
Come on, this guy.
Fats lost a lot in the storm, including the National Medal of Arts Award given to him by President Clinton. But on the one-year anniversary of Katrina, it was replaced by President George W. Bush, in large part thanks to Fats' friend, David Lind.
At the first birthday that he had in this house, which was 06, you were here.
I was here, yeah.
You were here. There are pictures over there of this occasion. Anyway, I was here with my two daughters, and his daughter said, can you get the medal reissued? I said, he's the only person who ever got it without being there, and now you want me to do it again? But anyway, that's what happened. I sent a letter to President Bush. I sent another one to President Clinton because Clinton had originally awarded the medal, but he wasn't president anymore. He gave him the medal in the house. They took pictures. It was hotter than the hinges of Hades in there, I remember that. And it was just the 10 of us plus Secret Service and President and Mrs. Bush. And it was so surreal because it was hot in there. It was very quiet. Nobody was there. There was no brouhaha. And then we walked out of the door of the little house.
And all the cameras
house.
Were there.
There
yeah.
were 40 or 50 or 60 cameras out there, including one from WWL, I do believe.
Fats was so impressed the president came to see him, he told Mr. Bush he'd take him up on his offer to come to the White House. They called the next day.
White House called him. He called me. He said, David, you got me into this. You got to go with me. So I said, let me think about it.
And so you went to the White House, and I got a call from Fats that night at the White House because I had given him a tie at that birthday party we were talking about in 2006.
We were standing in, there's a room that lines up perfectly with the Washington Monument. So you look out of that window, and there's the Washington Monument. Behind that is Lincoln. And it was just, it's kind of, am I really here? Am I in the White House with Fats Domino, and we're about to go tell President and Mrs. Bush hello? And that's when he called you. Fats, call somebody. Call somebody and tell them where you are. And he called you. And
he goes, I'm wearing your tie. I said, oh, that's kind of cool, Fats.
Oh, it was awesome. It was awesome. And pink, you know, it's here it is.
Pink was it, yeah.
Pink is a rock and roller color, right?
Well, when I saw the tie, I saw it in the store, and it was pink with all these rhinestones and stuff down it and stuff. I said, that's Fats Domino.
Coming up next, we'll talk with two of Fats' grandkids who knew Antoine Fats Domino as Papa Twan.
Here come Tuesday, oh, Tuesday, I'm so tired.
Here is Fats Domino singing Blueberry Hill.
Found my thrill.
Fats had a big family, 8 children and 13 grandchildren, and two of his grandchildren are with us today. Shevis Brimmer and Aaron Hartzog, thank you for coming in. Both your moms were daughters of Fats Domino. And you have a lot of personal memories of Fats.
Well, he had a wonderful personality. I mean, I spent a lot of time with him. I often would come over and visit him on Sundays, and we would just have lunch together, and he was just always so joyful, just innocent, just kept a smile. He called me the piano player, you know, ever since I was little.
Do you play piano?
A little bit. He taught me a little something. Not much. I mean, that takes time. I mean, everyone's not my grandfather, so.
No.
Yeah, he's just an awesome man, and I mean, I really do miss him.
And you guys had a special night at the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. They were giving a special award for Dave Bartholomew and Fats Domino. Fats couldn't make it. Dave went up there, and you guys represented your grandpa.
It was the American Music Masters Award with the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame and Museum. And he honored my grandfather and Dave Bartholomew because of the music. It was a great occasion. I really got a chance to see firsthand how the world felt about my grandfather and his music.
Did you understand that growing up, just how big of a deal Fats Domino was?
Not at all.
Not at all.
It really, as I got older, more and more, like I would go places, I would hear his music. Being at the Jazz Fest at a young age, seeing posters of him, it's just like, wow, that's Grandpa. And then when I really got older, once I really came of age, it was just like, wow, like he impacted a lot of people. Like, this is my grandfather.
And I know, because when I first met Fats Domino, the first thing I'm thinking is, oh my God, that's Fats Domino.
Right.
But for you, that's Granddad.
Yeah, absolutely. And the first time I got a chance to realize how famous he was and how he affected people was seeing him perform at the New Orleans Jazz Fest.
With all the great music and all the great musicians we have here in New Orleans, there are two men who changed the music of the entire world. One of them was Louis Armstrong, The other one is about to join us now. Please welcome the king of New Orleans rhythm and blues, Fats Domino.
I'm walking, yes indeed, I'm talking about you and me. I'm hoping that you come back to me. I'm lonely as not to be. I'm waiting for your company. I'm hoping that you come back to me.
I was backstage in 2001 for that performance, and just the swarms and seas of people that was out there, it was amazing. It was truly a sight to see.
To this day, you know, you mention him, you hear his name, people are just like, oh my gosh, Fats Domino, that's just, it's really amazing. And I'm just proud to be his granddaughter, you know, like especially now, like having his legacy live on, and it just means a lot. And I know he meant a lot to the world, but to me, he was just Papa Twan.
Yeah.
Simply Papa Twan.
Is there anything you want to tell folks about your grandfather? That
he loved his fans. He definitely loved his fans. He loved his food.
Yes, I remember going into his house in Night War when I was young, and he was always cooking. I'm like, what's that weird smell? Chitterlings. He loved to cook. That was just one of the many talents that.
And he loved his family.
He loved family.
For sure.
Family for sure.
I'll have some final thoughts on Fats Domino after this.
Finally tonight, many of you have asked, what should the city of New Orleans do to pay tribute to Fats Domino? After all, he was one of this city's greatest international music ambassadors, a native son who loved New Orleans and never left here. Fats Domino's music will live on forever. His influence is still being felt around the world, and what he did for rock and roll music is immeasurable. Whatever the city does, it needs to be as big as the man born Antoine Dominique Domino Jr. But in our hearts will always be the fat man, Fats Domino.
You made me cry when you said goodbye. Ain't that a shame? Mine just felt like rain. Ain't that a shame? You're the one to blame.
You guys are the best.
All right.
You're the best.
It's all right.
Hey, I think it's my birthday, not Fancy's.
Yeah.
He made me sure to take the drink.